Well, as you probably noticed, I'm gone and have been for the last couple days. I wanted you guys to be able to experience the flame test lab, but I'm not going to have 10 Bunsen burners running with random things being dipped in them while I'm gone. So I'm doing the flame test lab for you. You guys get to watch it and see what happens. If you notice, there's some weird colors. I put a diffraction grating over the camera lens to be able to make it so that not only can you see the color of the flame, but hopefully you'd be able to kind of get an idea of what the spectrum it breaks into. It's not going to be the best spectrum because normally you view it through a very narrow slit, so you get the distinct lines. Since we've got the wide flame, you're going to get a bunch of wide lines that kind of overlap each other off to the side. But still, I thought it would be kind of a neat effect and a fun way to watch the lab. So I'm going to turn off the lights, do the lab. As I put each chemical in there, I will have the video get paused for a second to make sure you have time to get observations down. There are 12 different substances we're testing. Here's a list of substances. Make sure you're getting these down on your paper. And we'll start. Six. That's better. Substance 12. All right, so now you guys can go back, look through your data, and you need to decide if it's the metal, the cation part of the thing, the calcium, sodium, barium, what have you, part of the compound that's determining the color, or if it is the anion part, the part that comes at the end of the formula, the sulfate, the nitrate, the chloride, see if that's what's determining the color. So if all the sulfates look the same color, well then, and all the chlorides look the same color, and all the nitrates, well then it must be the anion that causes the color. If all the sodiums, if all the bariums, if all the coppers look the same color, well then it must be the cation that determines it. Now, if they're not all identical anywhere, well, then neither one determines and it's a mixture. Or if one part seems to be more strongly affecting than the other, then maybe you can say that maybe the anion affects it more strongly, but the cation seems to affect it a little bit too. So you look back through your data and decide.